First question is, a government shop announces a flat 50% discount on every purchase of items for their customers. Draw the graph for the relation between the marked price and the discount. Hence, find the subdivision 1, marked price, when a customer gets a discount of 3,250 from the graph. And the second one is the discount when the marked price is 2,500 rupees. Now we shall solve the problem, because here they have given the relation between, so they have given 50% discount and they have mentioned, that is the relation between the marked price and the discount. Therefore, marked price and discount, we can take it as a variables, that is x equal to marked price and y equal to discount. Here we can write the values of x and y, and we can create the table. Here the government shop announces the flat 50% discount means. So we can take a or maximum or minimum value of government. Each government can be taken as a, you can take it as a 100 or 500. Here I have chosen as a 500. So if a garment or if a cloth is or if a dress is 500, then another dress will be 1,000, 1,500, 2,000, 2,500, 3,000, 3,500, and goes on. So we can take nearly 5 to 6 values. Okay, then if we give the 50% discount, then half of the price will be reduced. Therefore, if the marked price is 500, that you can write marked price is 500, then the discount price we are going to find out. Okay, so this everything is in rupees only. So here the discount rate will be 500, means the half of the 50% means here you can write 250. Then 1,000 means the half of the 50% discount if we give, then for the 1,000, 50% means 500. For the 1,500, you can write 750. Okay. You can write it as 750. Then 2,000 means 50%. For the 2,000, 1,000. For the 2,500, 1,250. Then for the 3,000, 50% discount means the half value is 1,500. Then for the 3,500, we can make it as 1,750. Okay, in the table, you can see that here one of the value increases and another value also increases. Can you guess? Here 500, 1,000, 1,500, 2,000, 2,500, 3,000, 3,500, which means the x values are increasing. The x values are increasing. Next, look at the y values. 250, 500, 750, 1,000, 1,250, 1,500, 1,750. This values also increases. So therefore, we can write that, that is, in the table, x values are increasing and y values also increasing. That is, in the table, x increases and y also increases. Therefore, it is a direct variation. So equation for this direct variation is y equal to kx. So the y value, the first table itself we can choose, that is 250. So we need to find the k value here. So for the x value we have assumed here, that is 500. So if we divide it, that you can write it here as it is, that is k equal to, that you can bring the multiplication when it comes to the next side, then it becomes y by x, that is 250 divided by 500, that is k equal to, if we divide, we'll get 1 and we get 2, that is 1 by 2. So the k value equal to 1 by 2. Therefore, points to be plotted. from the table we can write, that is 500 comma 250, 100 comma 50, because x comma y we will write the pairs. So therefore we can write 500 comma 250, 1000 comma 500, 1500 comma 750, 2000 comma 1000, 2500 comma 1250, and 3000 comma 1500, and 3500 comma 1750. So solution for this, we need to find when discount is 3250, the marked price we need to find from the graph. When marked price is 2500, we have to find the discount price in the graph. So for that, we can plot the graph, that is, for the x-axis, you can mark x, x dash and the origin point, and y dash and y point, we can mark it, that is, and then you can write the scale. Here we have chosen the values 500. So in both the cases, x-axis 1 centimeter equal to 500 units you can write, y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 500 units we can write. Okay, then according to the 500, you can plot the values 500, 1000, 1500 in such a way to the x-axis. The same way for the y-axis, you can write it 500, 1000, 1500, 2000 as it is you can write. Here we have chosen that x equal to marked price and y equal to discount. So we can write it here as a marked price and y equal to discount we can mark it. Now we shall plot the points 500 comma 250. So 500 will be here, the 250 will be here. So between this half of the value is 250. So 500 comma 250 you can write, and then the next point is 1000 comma 500. So 1000 and this will be 1000 comma 500, we can make it. The next one, 1500 comma 750. So the 1500 comma 750 means it comes here. Okay, so I have written on this point. So 1500 comma 750, so this point will be, then 2000 comma 1000. So 2000 comma 1000 means we get the point here, that is 2000 comma 1000 will get here, and then the another point 2500 comma 1250, 2500 will be here, then 1250 means we get the point for the 250, it meets here. So 2500 comma 1250, and then we can write 3000 comma 1500. 3000 will be this is, and this will be, you can write 3000 comma 1500, and then we can write 3500 comma 1750 means this point, 3500, then 1750, we can write it here. Then we can join all the points that we have plotted. After joining this line, so it passes through the origin. Now we need to write the equation on this linear equation. So the equation will be k equal to 1 by 2, that is y equal to 1 by 2x. So the values will be 1 by 2x because the k value is 1 by 2. So therefore we can write y equal to x by 2. We can write it here. Now we need to find the solution for this. That is, when discount is 3250 and we have to find the marked price. So therefore, where is it? 3250 means this line, okay? So 3250 means we can just do this. 3250. So this line tells that is 3250 rupees. This point reaches the linear equation at for the x-axis to the 6500. So we can join this line also. Therefore, answer for this first subdivision is 6500. The same way we need to find the value for second one. When marked price is 2500, where is the marked price? It is in x-axis. So 2500 will be here. So we need to find the discount for this. Now you can see that 2500, this vertical line joins at the point of linear equation, and it shows the value of 1250 in the y-axis. So therefore, when marked price is 2500, the discount is rupees 1250. Second question, we shall see that through the graph of xy equal to 24, x, y greater than 0. Using the graph, find y when x equal to 3 and find x when y equal to 6. Here in the question itself, they have given the equation xy equal to 24. So from this equation, we have to find whether it is a direct variation or inverse variation or indirect variation. So xy equal to 24. That is, we can write it in the equation form that y equal to 24 divided by x. That is, this equation is in the form of y equal to k by x. So if it is in the division, that is called a indirect variation. So we need to prepare the table for the graph. Okay. So to find the values of y when x equal to 3 and find the value of x when y equal to 6. So for that, we need to prepare the table that x, y. So in the place of x, we are going to apply the numbers above the 1. Okay, which means here x, y greater than 0, they have mentioned in the question itself. Therefore, x up to 0, we are going to use the positive numbers, that is 1. Okay, when we substitute 1 and in the denominator, we get 24 divided by 1, we get 24. When we substitute 2, here we get 24 divided by 2, we get 12 2s are 24. Therefore, we get 12. Here 3. Then when you substitute the 3, what you get? 8 3s are 24. And 4 6s are 24. When you substitute here, okay, if you substitute 5, we get a decimal number. So in such a way, we have to substitute the numbers so that we won't get any remainder. So therefore, we skip the 5 and we come to the 6 table. If we divide it by 6, we get 4. And by the 8 table, if we divide it, then we get 3. Okay, so maximum 6 points are here. So with this, we can stop it. And we can compare that. Whether the check the x values 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8. So x values are increasing. And here, look at the y values 24, 12, 8, 6, 4, 3. These values are decreasing. If one of the value is increased and when one of the value is decreased, that variation is called inverse variation. Therefore, we can write that in the table x increases and y decreases. Therefore, it is an inverse variation. Now we completed the table and we found the equation. So next we are going to plot the points. So points to be plotted here. From the table, you can write 1, 24, 2, 12, 3, 8, 4, 6, 6, 4 and 8, 3. So all these values we are going to plot in the graph. That I have prepared already, and you can prepare the graph by writing x, x dash and y dash and y. Okay, and just use the origin point. Now here the values of the table are single digit, and up to, for the y axis we have up to 24. So you can take the scale rate, that is x equal to x axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit, but y axis you just write it as 1 centimeter equal to 2 unit. Here I have write it as a 1 unit, so here I did not get any space, so you just take it as a 2 units and write it in the y axis. Now let's plot the values, that is 1, 24, 2, 12. So how can we write 1, 24 will come to the, I think it will go over the graph, so I just keep the point here, that is 1, 24. So the next point 2, 12 and 3, 8. So 2, 12, where lies 2? In x-axis 2 lies here and the 12 lies here, so in horizontal way. So 2, 12. The next one is 3, 8. So 3 lies here up to 8. Okay, when you take 2 units, when you take 2 units you will get shorter graph. Since I have taken the 1 unit, so it goes beyond the graph page. Now we shall take this 3, 8. Next 4, 6. And next 6, 4. Next 8, 3. That is 8. Here comes the 3. So now we are going to draw the curve by joining all these points. Okay, shall we do it? With free hand we can join all these points. Okay, if you join all these points we get a curve. We get a curve. That curve is called rectangle hyperbola. This curve is called rectangle hyperbola. Now we are going to find the solution for the problem. When x equal to 3, what is y value? So when x equal to 3, what is y value? So we are going to draw the vertical line to this curve and we are going to find out the y axis. The same way for the y equal to 6, for the y equal to 6 we are going to find out the x value. Therefore we get the point when x equal to 3, this vertical line meets to the y axis at 8. So this y axis 6 meets the curve at vertically to the x axis at the point of 4. So we can write, that is when x equal to 3 the solution is 8, then y equal to 6 that x axis is 4. Okay, with this the sum gets over. Now we shall move to the third question. Graph the following linear function, that is y equal to 1/2x, and identify the constant of variation and verify it with the graph. Also find y when x equal to 9, find x when y equal to 7.5. So here in this question also they have given the equation 1/2x, y equal to 1/2x. So that we can write it as y equal to kx. So if we write in the multiplication form, it is called a direct variation. So which means the k value, we can easily find that 1/2 is a k value. So We can write this y equal to x by 2. But we need to remove this division so that we can get the direct variation in such a way, that is 2y equal to x also we can write it, okay. So here already I have said here k equal to 1 by 2 is a constant of variation. They have asked us to find out that, identify the constant of variation. So we found this one, okay. Now we are going to frame the table. So in the table, we have to remove this division of 2, denominator 2, so that the value of equation y equal to x or some other value we will get. Okay, so we have to remove this 2. So in such a way, we are going to apply the values for x so that we can get a 0 remainder. That is, if we substitute x for the 2, we get 2 divided by 2, we get 1. And if we substitute 3, we get a remainder. So we skip the 3 and go to the fourth one. So 4 divided by 2, we get 2. And 6 divided by 3, we get, 6 divided by 2, we get 3. And 8 by 2, we get 4. And 10 by 2, we get 5. So we have chosen the multiples of 2 to divide the denominator by 2. So now we completed the table. In the table, we can see the values of x. Here 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So all these values are increasing. Next, look at it. Look at the y values. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these y values also increasing. So there are same changes. If there are same changes, mean we can write it that, or we can say that it is a direct variation. Therefore, in the table, x increases, also y increases. So therefore, it is direct variation. Now we can plot the points, that is 2, 1, 4, 2, 6, 3, 8, 4, 10, 5. Therefore, points to be plotted was over. Now we are going to draw the graph. So here all the values are unit values. So therefore we can take the scale, that is x-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit, y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. So you can put the x and x dash, y dash and y for the graph, and you need to put the 0 for the origin point. Now we are going to plot the points, that is 2, 1. 2, 1 means it will come here. So 2, 1 was over. Next 4, 2. This is 4 and this point tells us 4, 2. Next 6, 3. This is 6 in the x-axis, for the y-axis comes here. Okay, 6, 3. Next 8, 4. In x-axis, the 8 is here. So 8, 4. And then the one more point is 5, 10. In x-axis 5. Sorry. 10, 5. So here change it. 10, 5 it is in the table. So 10, 5. So 10, 5. We get 5. So now just see this. All these points are get a straight line which may passes through the origin. So shall we join this line? Now we can write the equation, that is y equal to x by 2. And this line passes through the origin. Now we are going to find the solution when x equal to 9. What is the value of y. So when x equal to 9, so it meets here. So this point is 4.5. So that is 4.5. So we can join this line. And for the second subdivision, we are going to find when y equal to 7.5. When y equal to 7.5 and this line. Okay. So therefore, we need to extend this line. Here, when x equal to 9, we get 4.5. And when x equal to 7.5, we get this linear equation vertically meets at the x-axis to the y-axis, that is 15. So the value of x equal to 15. So the value of x equal to 15, with this the sum gets over.